Hello everyone. First of all, I want to tell that you can select, in addition of the subtitles in your language, also the audio in your language. Please check if there is also your. This calculator is the Olivetti Logos 27-2 from around 1967. It is probably the highest point ever reached in the development of electromechanical calculators, as well as one of the most complex consumer devices ever built. I start right away from the inside, where you can see its big complexity. It is made up of several thousand pieces, assembled in such a way as to perform all the arithmetic operations. Here, in fact, the calculations are not performed by electronic components as in current electronic calculators. Even if it seems strange, the calculations are performed by mechanical parts, assisted in their movements by a powerful electric motor. Its ancestor was the Olivetti Logos 27-1. The main difference between them is the number of totalizers, which in the 27-1 is only one totalizer, while in the 27-2 it's two totalizers. The Olivetti 27-1 was released in 1965, immediately showing problems of operation due to its complexity. With the Olivetti 27-2 was made an attempt to solve the problems manifested in the previous model by redesigning some details, however, without any real improvement. However, in the 1960s was emerging a market situation in which electronic devices, simpler and less expensive, were increasingly establishing themselves on the market. Therefore, the big effort of Olivetti to insist on this line of mechanical product, with production lines, special machinery, staff training, assistance, arrived too late and proved to be useless. It is a calculator that contains not trivial innovation that cannot be found on any other electromechanical calculator, even from other brands. And Olivetti believed a lot in this project, since was planned a plan of six models which never saw the light. The calculator, in the final version, included functions such as automatic square, automatic percentage, automatic download of the partial total of one of the two operating memories, automatic rounding, automatic transfer of partial results to the second totalizer, floating point. All this was done with mechanical solutions, therefore of incredible complexity. The calculator, as you can see, has a rather imposing appearance, and in fact, it is the heaviest of its period, with a weight of 27 kilograms. The design is by Ettore Sottsass, and it was actually planned that it would be installed on a small table that would make it more discreet in the office environment. The Logos 27 has a power button that it is not present on all other calculators, because electromechanical calculators are practically always on standby and do not absorb anything, because they do not have LEDs or other devices to keep on. In this machine, however, having an electrified keyboard, the machine must be ready to receive a command, so it must be turned on, and there is an idle cycle that runs to allow the machine to be used. So in this case, it was necessary to add a real power button. For maintenance, it was necessary to be able to access the machine from all six sides. And so there was also a specific table for maintenance, which allowed you to turn the machine around to look at it from all sides. The customer service department had created a guide for locating the parts. This one here, which looks like a map of New York built in three dimensions, where you had to find the coordinate of the position where the problem was, for example, in position B3. And as long as the part to be changed was visible and easily accessible on the reference map, it was fine. But if the broken part was in the middle of the calculator, then it was a problem. There was another 300-page technical publication, this one, full of diagrams, charts, and tables. Here it says that if there is a specific problem, it is probably due to a piece that you find in front view in square G2, and therefore you have to go hunting for the broken piece. It is said that the maintenance courses for these calculators were terrible. You had to understand the detailed functioning of the machine, so piece by piece, what it was for, what it did, the adjustments, and therefore what the relationship between piece and piece had to be, if there had to be a space of a few tenths of millimeters, how much the pieces had to be in contact, if it was an area that had to be lubricated with grease, with oil, the relative timing of the pieces, etc. It's something already complicated for a simple machine, you can imagine, on a complex machine like this. According to my personal estimate, it should consist of a number of 5,000 to 7,000 pieces, which must rotate in synchrony, perfectly lubricated, at crazy speeds, up to 600 cycles per minute, with peaks of 1,000 cycles during multiplications. To obtain mechanical parts with particularly complex geometries, it was decided to use sintering technology. The problem with sintered parts is that they can achieve excellent precision, but unfortunately, they are fragile pieces, and the machine broke them. Other machines had been mechanically conceived as modular. Here everything is truly an indissoluble tangle of pieces. Without taking anything away from the geniuses who designed it. It is a very interesting machine. Nowadays it seems incomprehensible that enormous resources are invested in a device of this kind. But Olivetti had built its fortune on mechanics and was reluctant to let go. However, even if Olivetti failed with this product, losing a lot of money, this calculator will remain forever as an example of human ingenuity. And thanks to Emanuele for the valuable information he gave me on these calculators. Have a nice day.